Hi there, so this video is dedicated to HTTP request and mainly as well to API. So it's really a short introduction, right? I'm not going to get into detail about everything, but just to explain you the general concept. So often you will heard about HTTP requests. So HTTP requests refer to, in fact, demands which are made either by client or server. Most of the time it's by clients to servers, and servers are the machines which you can contact with HTTP requests, and thanks to special programs which are named APIs, Application Programming Interface, which are here in order to say, okay, we are a company, we are an organization, we have a server which is hosting a lot of data. And as we don't want you to go on our website right away and scrap all the different pages and download too many things that you really need, we open for you an API in order to give you the possibility to just grab the data that you are looking for. So typically here I'm playing with an API, which is the one of Bitfinex, which is a cryptocurrency trading platforms. And on this given platform, I have the possibility to call, as you can see, many different methods in order to just grab the information that I want. So most of the time when you go through HTTP request or API documentation website, you will see things like this telling you how you can request the different data in the different programming language. And you can get most of the time an example of the kind of data that you can extract. So let's imagine that I would like to make an HTTP request to this given website. As you can see, you can use curl. So curl is in fact a method that you can call thanks to your terminal in order to make an HTTP request. So here I'm using what we call a public API. It means that I do not need any credential, but if you are using API, you will see that most of the time they will ask you to register, and once you register you get a token, and this is this token which represents your identifier plus your password, which is used in order to make the call to the API, because you have to know that every time that you use an API you are somehow consuming some bandwidth. It's not good for the server, so that's why most of the time the API are not public and require a token. So I'm copying just this line of code and I'm going to make an HTTP request call just like this. So when I'm doing it like this, as you can see, it's giving me out the result of the request, and here in my case it's giving me the price of Bitcoin compared to dollar, which is close to $10,000. And this is what I wanted to show you about how you can make easily HTTP requests thanks to your computer. I'm going to show you another example, mostly linked with connected devices, in order for you to have a kind of an extra example. So let's imagine I'm going to just connect my smartphone. So I'm just going to do something like this, AI companion, and then I'm going to go back over here. Okay, connect, oops. And I'm gonna create an app which will actually make as well an HTTP request like this. It would make more sense. So if I wish my digital device to make an HTTP request, I need to have a component in order to make it. So I'm gonna go over here into connectivity. I'm gonna take a component which is called web, and as a result, web will make the HTTP request. Then in order to fire this given request, what I will do is I'm going to add the button like this, and I'm going to add the label where I will store in fact the answer of the request. So in fact, text for label here represents what I have up here, and the fact that here I press enter represents the fact that I'm going to push this given button. So I'm just going to make this little bit bigger, and I'm just going to make as well in 8 it a little bit bigger. Okay, all good. So now I need to give the instruction about the URL that I want to request. So in my case, that's the given URL, and the expected behavior that I want is if I push the button, I will get, instead of text for label, the answer of this given request. So now let's go to coding. So I just need to go over here. So if I click on the button, what I will do is I will make one of my HTTP request. So this is what we call either a post or a get request. Okay, so it's going to perform an HTTP get request, and it's going to get the results, and the results I wanted to be displayed. So when I got the answer, so when I got the text, what do I want? I want the label, so label text, to be filled in with the response content, not the response code, because response code is in fact different, correspond to the status, which are either 200 or either 400 if the request is not made properly. So here should be fine. So what I'm gonna do right now is I'm just gonna refresh the companion screen. Yep, and show you how it looks like. So just gonna make like reset the connection, and I'm just gonna connect it back. So here I'm gonna go back on my smartphone. I'm just gonna enter the given WFS disconnected. Wow, so lucky today. So WFN JHD and connect with code. Okay, connect with code. Yep. And if I now move back to my screen, which is the following one. Okay, so it's that should be the one. So if I click here on text for buttons, but it's not valid. Oh, okay, I see my error. It's I did the curl thing, so I should not have this one. And so now it should be better. So I just need to connect it back. So AI companion and yups, connect. So is the connection, and I need to connect it back. So connect it back and yups, like this. Okay. And if I now move back on my screen, so just the time for App Inventor to secure the connection. And if I click over here, yeah, as you can see, I'm getting the response. So that's everything that I wanted to show you today. It's all about a request that you make to what we call an endpoint, which is in fact the server to which you are going to make your request. And you get an answer, and thanks to this answer, after that's your job to filter the result in order to just grab the data that you are looking for. Hope this video helped you understand a little bit more about HTTP requests. Thanks for watching.